Hello there, welcome to this video. Here we are going to see how to create an HD intro video with Adobe After Effects CC. Leave feedbacks in comments to improve our pronunciation. Adobe After Effects is one of the best softwares to make professional intro videos. Our goal here is to know the basis of how to create one. Mind that you will need further time and practice to make awesome intros in the future. In case you are in distress, there will be annotations guiding you on what you don't know yet. This is the simple intro we are going to make. This intro has inside all you need to make professional intros in the future, besides it is very simple on its own. Download the project in the video description to see how it has been composed. An intro video is basically composed by three parts. The video loops, there are basic videos on which you show text. The text itself that is used to present your username and animator subtitle. And the soundtracks or audio effects in background. The video loops and the soundtracks can be found on the net also for free. Mind that, not to infringe copyrights, you must check the licenses that are applied on such files. Make sure that what you download is under a Creative Commons license that lets you use the files freely and with full permissions. With an idea in mind, download the video loops and the audio tracks you need. Download some of them, so that you can pick up the right one while building your project. In our case we have three parts, the first two showing sides of the username and the third one to show it fully. We can separate them simply through a full transparency level. After opening AE, create a new composition. To make it in HD, choose a 1280 by 720 resolution or 1920 by 1080 for the 1080p. This will be your main composition, the one containing all your project. Then drag inside all the files you need. We can start with the video loop, defining the three parts we have in mind. Just go to Transform section and click on the watch to add keyframes. Change from 0% to 100% and vice versa, where you want the transitions in opacity. Reduce the opacity in the end of the intro to come back to black. Usually intros aren't longer than 10 or 12 seconds. Don't care about what is next at the end of the video. We can also change the speed of the particles in this video. Simply drag on the clip the time warp effect. Always using the keyframes, you can make them slower in the first two parts and accelerate in the third to make motion. If you have problems with the effects, watch the related video in this show. Then we can go on with the text. Text is used to present your username that must be in people's mind. Its font must fit the rest of the intro style. So while the project goes on, you may need to come back to change the kind of text. In our kind of project, the text must be very big and in white color. It will be cooler if we show a 3D text. So we simply need a solid layer and a shutter effect on it. Go to Layer, New and then to Solid. For the 3D extrusion that comes next, the color of the solid layer is important. It is usually better to choose a dark gray color. Then simply search for the shutter effect and drag it on the solid layer. Under Force 1 section, choose an high value for depth. This will stop the motion of the shutter effect. Now we just need to change the bricks to the text itself to make such in 3D. Under Shape section, choose Custom in Pattern and the text in Custom Shutter Map. This is going to work if it is selected a composition. So just go to the text, right click and go to Pre-compose to place the text inside a composition that doesn't change its properties. If you choose this composition in the shutter map, you will obtain the same text but in 3D. Then you can hide the 2D text composition since we just need it in 3D. To know more about the 3D text, watch the related video in this show. Now we want this 3D text at a customized color and move it, for example, from right to left. To preserve the 3D effect, the motion must be done through a camera. Go to Layer, to New and then to Camera. Accept with OK. To make the motion effective, go to Camera System and select Com Camera. In this way, the point of view is set by the camera you just added. Then click on Unify the Camera tool to set how the 3D text must show up. Mind that not the whole username is shown, since the 3D shutter effect is applied on the visible text at its origin. To move from right to left, we can simply use keyframes on point of interest, changing just the X coordinates, so the first ones from the left. Then to make the text lighter, we can add a spotlight. Go to Layer, New and then to Light. In the Shutter Effect box, go to Lightning and choose a First Comp Light to set the light on your own. You can set it properly using the Cartesian axis shown in the preview, changing point of view to check its position in 3D. You won't need to move the light in time, since we set motion through the camera. All that is inside the preview is going to move, such as the text inside or the light itself. If you want to improve the color even more, just go to the Shutter Effect box, go to Textures and select the username comp as a front layer. Then, to put some color to the text and the video loop used, we can use a colored filter. Go again to Layer, New and to Solid. Choose a white background this time. Then search for gradient ramp in the effects list and drag it on the white layer. This lets you choose any color and even a gradient. We can choose, for example, a radial gradient using the same colors of the original video loop. This will give color to the text. Make sure to put some more transparency. Then, to add a customized color, create a new composition that will contain all the text used and all the solid layers associated. Then cut all such layers and paste them in this composition. You may need to link again comps in the shutter box. All you need is to add a hue saturation effect to this text composition and give to all layers inside the color you like most. Make sure to put the text composition on top or the text won't show up. Then, since the text composition has inside the white solid layer with the radial gradient, this will be a color filter for the video loop as well. Then, to finish this first part, we need to synchronize the 3D text opacity levels with the ones set on the video loop before. Go in the whole text composition and adjust the opacity levels, making them all equal to the keyframe set for the video loop. Very well, the first part is done. To make the second one, you won't need to repeat this mess. Simply duplicate the dark gray layer and create a new username comp. Make sure to duplicate it and not to copy and paste, or you won't go through. Rename these and place them in the second part of the intro. Now the text username must be placed much more on the left. The duplicating dark gray layer will turn this again to 3D. All you need this time is to change the custom shutter map, updating it to the second username text, and the same for the front layer in textures. Hide the 2D text and the second part is already finished. Just set motion to the second part through the camera as you did before. The third part will need a third username text that is shown completely on the preview. So again, create the text and adjust it. Then duplicate the dark gray layer and change the custom shutter map again with the textures, the same exact process. Let's suppose now to have this third text rotating for a while and then being fixed on the center. The camera makes all. If we don't use the camera, the 3D effect risks to be ineffective, and we should set manually the light as well. The inclination of the text is ruled through the position section of the camera. Activate the clock and set the keyframes in time using the Unified Camera tool. You are totally free in making the text motion. This is just one of infinity examples. The basic structure is basically done. You can add further effects, but this is totally up to you. For example, you can use the CC Fast Radial Blur to the dark gray layer, moving the center from left to right, but you can use other possible effects. If you want, you can add a subtitle too. Add a new text composition and a dark gray layer as you did before. In this case, for example, we can make it appear after fixing the username, so we set the opacity at 100% in the middle of the third part. We can add effects too, for example using the scatter effect that fits the particles appearing in this video loop. If you are interested, download the intro project in the video description. Then we can adjust the ending. A possible ending can be to transform the intro into particles while it is being faded away in the end. Again, we can use the scatter effect, adjusting in time through the keyframes the way you like most. Not to repeat this effect to any layer, it is enough to apply it to the layers of your main composition, so that the effect is applied on any sublayer inside. Last thing to do is to add some sound. In this case, many solutions are possible. Just make sure to use soundtracks or audio effects that do fit the whole intro. In this case, we chose to use a simple audio soundtrack that fits very well. Since the length may be longer than the video, you may need to adjust sound too. It is enough to add keyframes on audio levels to set where the soundtrack has to start and where to finish. Plus, the waveform can guide you at placing the layer at the right position. Keep in mind that the space button plays just the visible parts of a video. To play it in full, so video plus audio, you need to press 0 from your number pad. This is called the RAM preview. The video is charged into your computer memory first, and then it is played. In this way you can listen to the soundtrack and change its placement in order to set where it has to be. At this point you just need to render. Since your main composition is already in HD, you won't need anything else to do. Mind that, to get very high quality, it is better to render in .avi in full resolution and high quality. That's all, don't mind if your first intro may be not like this or worse. To start making good intros, you do need further practice. Thanks for watching, don't miss our other videos in this show.